Hi all, today we are going to discuss about the short transmission lines. So the short transmission line is one whose length is less than 80 kilometers and generally the voltage is less than 20 kV. So in this case, as the length is less, the variation of the voltage with respect to the distance, as the distance is varying, because we have seen in the last class that lambda or the wavelength is equal to 6000 kilometers. So this is what we have seen in the last class. That means after every 6000 kilometers, the waveform will repeat or the variation will be there with the waveform as you are going with respect to the distance in kilometer. So if the length is up to 80 kilometers, generally the effect is very less, the variation is less, so the parameters can be taken as lumped parameters. And the second one is, due to the distance is less and the voltage is also less, the effect of the capacitive current, because we know studied in last class that it will be V into omega C. The value of this capacitive current depends on the voltage as well as the value of the capacitance. And this capacitance in the transmission line, if you take the line, the capacitances are distributed like this. So if you take each capacitance value as C, in this example, the total capacitance will be equal to 3 times of C. That means C is again depending on the value of the distance. So that's why, as the distance and voltage is less, we can neglect the effect of the capacitive current, or we can neglect the value of the capacitance. So that then the resultant line is called as short transmission line. So in the short transmission line, we will represent like this. There will be a resistance R, and the inductive reactance is given by X. Let us assume the sending end current is IS and the receiving end current is IR. So sending end voltage I am representing by VS and the receiving end voltage is VR. So let us take them as vectors, so or the phasors. So these are the values of the phasors or different locations. So now I can draw the phasor diagram for this. So if you are taking my IR, that means receiving end current, as my reference vector. So from that I can calculate this is my value of VR. So for the VR I have to add IR into R, and for this I have to add IR into XR or IR into X. So this is J times. So this is what we get. So the resultant of this, so we get the value of, this is my value of the sending end voltage. So this angle, whatever is obtained, this angle is called as sending end power factor angle theta S, and this angle is called as the theta R or phi R. So whatever you take it, some books they write phi, some books theta. Let us take phi only, so that confusion will not. So now if you want to calculate the value of VS, you already know the value of VR, IR as well as R and X. How to calculate this? So this can be calculated by taking my IR as my reference. So if you are taking IR as my reference, so I am taking IR as reference, and you are calculating the value of, let us assume R and X are per phase resistance and reactance. This is the total per phase resistance and reactance of the transmission line. So from this I can subtend this. So I can write my Vs. Let us assume this value of the vector Va, I am taking the magnitude. So Vs cos phi s. So Vs cos phi s is that Vs projected in the direction of x plane. That means this is the value. So this value I can write as a sum of. So I am not writing this bar and writing the magnitude instead of confusion. I am simply writing Vr. If I am not writing the bar on the top, it indicates it is a scalar quantity or the magnitude only. Please remember this. So cos phi r plus ir into r. That ir into r is projected there. So let us take this as equation number 1. So similarly, I can write my value of Vs sin phi s. So Vs sin phi s is this component. So this component I can write as Vr sin phi r plus, the second value will be IR into X. Let us take this as equation number 2. So from this I can calculate my value squaring on both sides and summing this equation number 1 and 2. That means I am taking 1 square plus 2 square. So this will become Vs square. This will be equal to, we have to take the first term square plus second term square. So this will become Vr cos phi r plus IR into R square plus Vr sin phi r plus ir into x square. So this I can write as Vr square cos square phi r plus ir square into r square plus 2 times of Vr ir into r into cos phi r. This is for the first one. And the second term, this will become Vr square sin square phi r plus ir square x square plus 2 times of Vr into IR into X into sin phi R. So this I can summarize. So this one and this one I can combine. this becomes Vr square into cos square phi r plus sin square phi r will become 1, plus the second term becomes Ir square into r square plus x square, plus the remaining two terms will be as it is. So this remaining two terms becomes 2 times of Vr into Ir into r cos phi r plus 2 times of Vr into Ir into x into sin phi r. So from this I can calculate my value of the Vs. So how to calculate the Vs? You have to take the square root on the second side. So this I will become equal to Vr into 1 plus Vr I am taking as a common. So this becomes 2 times of Vr Ir into r into cos phi r, this Vr divided by Vr square. So this is what comes, plus 2 times of Vr Ir into x into sin phi r by Vr square, plus Ir square into r square plus x square divided by Vr square. This is what is obtained. So this I can further simplify. So here Vr square and Vr will cancel here. Similarly, Vr and Vr square, one square will cancel here. So this total power will be 1 by 2. I forget to write this. So from this I can calculate my value of Vs, because this I can expand using Taylor series expansion. So we can do Taylor series expansion and neglecting higher order terms. So if you are neglecting the higher order terms, so this I can write as Vr into 1 plus, so the second component will become Ir into r into cos phi r divided by Vr, plus Ir into x into sin phi r divided by Vr, if you are expanding using Taylor series expansion. So this I can write in a simplified form, that Vs is approximately equal to Vr plus Ir into r into cos phi r plus Ir into x into sin phi r. This is the approximate value. So from this I can calculate my value of Vs minus Vr. So Vs minus Vr will be approximately equal to Ir into r into cos phi r plus Ir into x into sin phi r. So let us remember this, because this will be useful again. So let us now see how the regulation can be calculated. So we have to, our purpose is to calculate the regulation and the efficiency, because we are calculating the performance of transmission lines. So percentage regulation is nothing but the receiving end voltage under no load conditions minus receiving end voltage divided by receiving end voltage into 100. This is what we have seen in the last class. So this Vr dash under no load conditions, you can just go to this diagram. Under no load conditions, the value of Ir is equal to 0. So obviously Is also will be equal to 0. So whatever is my sending end voltage, same thing will be received at the receiving end. So we can tell that this Vs minus Vr, that Vr dash under no load conditions will be nothing but equal to sending end voltage. So we can simply write this as Vs minus Vr divided by Vr into 100. So Vs minus Vr we have already calculated. So just I am substituting the value which we have calculated. So this Vs minus Vr we have calculated as Ir into r into cos phi r is by Vr, plus Ir into x into sin phi r divided by Vr. So this multiplied by 100. So this I can represent in per unit also. So let us represent in per unit. So regulation in per unit, this will be equal to Ir r cos phi r divided by Vr, plus Ir into x into sin phi r divided by Vr. That 100 will not be there. So this is nothing but if you are taking your receiving end voltage and receiving end current as your base values, that means I am taking Vr and Ir as base values. You can see here you are multiplying the, dividing your drop. Your drop you are dividing with the base value. Similarly, drop in the reactance you are dividing with the base value. This is not the, nothing but the per unit value. So this I can write as, that regulation in per unit I can write as, so let us take it represent as V, small v suffix r cos phi r plus small vx into sin phi r, where this vr, small vr, represent the per unit resistance. We have already seen, discussed in the transformers, what is this per unit values. So this is per unit reactance. This is the per unit reactance. So in order to get the zero voltage regulation, how we will get? This voltage regulation will be equal to zero. That means this Vr cos phi r plus Vx sin phi r should be equal to zero. This is for zero voltage regulation. For zero voltage regulation, you have to take this. So if you this class simplify this, so you will get as tan phi r is equal to minus r by x, or this I can write as tan of phi r plus phi by 2. This will be equal to x by r. This will become reverse if you are taking this. Or from this, I can calculate my value of the receiving end. That receiving end power factor angle will be minus phi by 2 plus tan inverse of x by r. This is the condition for zero voltage regulation. You can see here zero voltage regulation is coming as minus pi by 2 plus tan inverse of x by r. Generally, it will be less than 90 degrees. So we can tell that the regulation is 0 for leading power factor loads. That means when the loads are leading power factor loads, then only regulation will be maximum. So we can tell that under lagging power factor condition, the regulation will be positive only. Let us try to calculate what is the maximum voltage regulation. So we know that for maximum voltage regulation, so we have to differentiate D divided by phi r, because regulation is depending on only variable is receiving end angle. So that D regulation divided by D phi r is equal to 0. If you calculate the D phi r, so we can tell that 0 is equal to, so if you are differentiating this one, that means regulation we got that IR into R cos phi r by VR, IR into X sin phi r by ER, IR R by VR is constant. So only variable here is cos phi r. So D by DX of cos phi r is minus sin phi r. So I am writing that here IR into R into sin phi r divided by VR plus IR into X divided by VR into cos phi r. So from this I can calculate my value of phi r is equal to tan inverse of X by R. You can see this angle will be positive. So we can tell that this happens in the case of lagging power factor conditions. Now coming to the efficiency. So we can calculate the efficiency, percentage efficiency. You can calculate by the receiving end power. Let us take the three phase power at the receiving end is P. So this will become P divided by P plus. Here only parameter where the power will loss will be resistance. So this becomes 3 times of IR square into R. This we have multiplied with 100. This way you have to calculate. So let us see, try to represent this transmission line in terms of ABCD parameters. So I am drawing the transmission line again. So that line can be represented like this. It is R plus JX. So this is my sending end voltage and this is my receiving end voltage. This is my sending end current and this is my receiving end current. So all are phasor, so I am taking these values. So now in the ABCD parameters, you have seen that the ABCD parameters can be represented as VS comma IS can be represented as, so let me erase this, VS comma IS will be equal to A, B, C, D. You have studied this in two port networks. I hope you already have the idea. Otherwise, I am going to teach these topics in network analysis. You can refer from there. So this will be in terms of VR and IR we are representing. All these are phasors. So this is the way you represent this, or this VR and IR I can represent in terms of the source values. So this value of VR comma IR, you have studied again in the ABCD parameter calculations, how to calculate receiving end parameters in terms of sending end parameters. That will become equal to D minus B minus CA. So this will be multiplied by VS and IS. So these are there. So let us try to write the equations for this. I can write the equation for VS will be nothing but VR plus IR. You have to multiply with the value of the impedance, where the value of the impedance is nothing but R plus JX. So this I am taking as my impedance, IR into impedance. Similarly, the value of the sending end current, because you can see here only this is a series parameters are there, shunt parameters are not there. So automatically the value of IS will be equal to IR. So from this, I can define my value of VS and IS as, so this will be 1, second one is coming as Z, this is 0 and 1 of VR comma IR. So from this we got the value of ABCD. A is equal to 1, B is equal to Z, C is equal to 0 and D is equal to 1. So if you know the sending end values, you want to calculate the receiving end values, you can just use this. You will write D here, A here, and B and C will be inverse. So here you can see here A is equal to D will be there, and AD minus BC is equal to 1. The two port network, whatever conditions are there, that condition will be satisfied here also. Now let us see, if you know the value of ABCD parameters, how can we calculate the value of regulation? because we know at no load conditions, we know the value of IR is equal to 0. So when you substitute IR is equal to 0 in the VS equation, so then automatically you are getting your VS will be equal to VR, because IR is equal to 0 in the above equation. So if you are substituting the ABCD parameters, so in the ABCD parameters, you write the equation for VS, because we know that VS is equal to A times of VR plus B times of IR. So here this IR is equal to 0, so I can write VS is equal to A times of VR. So when you are writing VR is equal to A times of VR, I can write VR is equal to VS divided by A. This is under no load conditions. We know the percentage regulation is nothing but VR dash minus VR divided by VR into 100, where VR dash is the corresponding to the no load condition. So no load condition, this is VS by A minus VR divided by VR into 100. You have to take the magnitude, so not these vectors. So this way you have to calculate. So let us take one example so that the complete concept what we have discussed will be completely clear to you. So I am taking one example, a 3-phase 5-kilometer long line having resistance of 0.5 ohms per kilometer and inductance of 1.76 millihenry per kilometer is delivering power at 0.8 power factor lagging. The receiving end voltage is 32 kV. If the supply end voltage is 33 kV 50 hertz, find the line current regulation and part C, efficiency of the transmission line. This is what is asked. So let us try to solve this. So for solving this, again, because based on the formulas, so it is given there, the sending end voltage is given as, because the receiving end voltage is 32 kV and the sending end voltage is given as 33 kV. Always you remember that unless specifically it is mentioned, always you have to take whatever parameters are given, they belong to 3-phase only. In AC circuit, please remember this. So this will become VS is equal to 33 divided by root 3. So you will get it as 19.052. kilovolts. Similarly, the receiving end voltage will be 32 divided by root 3. This will be 18.48 kV. And the value of resistance is given in per kilometer. Resistance is given in per kilometer. So we can calculate this as, this resistance is 0.5. You have to multiply with 5 kilometers. This will become 2.5 ohms. And similarly, the reactance will be equal to 2 pi FL gives your value of reactance. You have to multiply with the length, because length is 5 kilometers. So this will become 2 pi into 50 into 1.76 into 10 to the power of minus 3 multiplied by 5. So this becomes 2.765 ohms. So similarly, it is also given in the numerical that cos phi r is equal to 0.8. So this gives to sin phi r will be equal to 0.6, because we know if it is 0.8, you can calculate this. So above we have already discussed that VS square I can write as VR square plus 2 times of VR IR into R into cos phi R plus 2 times of VR IR into X into sin phi R plus IR square into X square plus R square. We are calculating the actual or exact equation. So when you substitute the known parameters here, this is VS square is equal to 362.98 will come. VR square will be 341.33. Plus we don't know the value of IR. So this IR, if you are taking separating out and remaining terms, if you calculate, so this will become IR multiplied by 135.24, because combination of these two will give this much. So please verify with your answer. And the last one will be IR square into this will become IR. So this is IR square, sorry, this will be IR into 6.25 plus 7.645. this will come, or otherwise if you simplify your value of the IR, you will get the value of the IR as two values. One is the positive value, second one is the negative value. If you simplify this, you will get this value as 0.157 kilo amperes. So this is what we get, because all the values are in kilo, so automatically current that is obtained also will be in kilo. So now coming to part B, it is asked to calculate the regulation. So regulation will be equal to VR square minus VR divided by VR into 100. We know for short transmission and under no load conditions, at no load, the value of VR square will be equal to VS. So we can write the percentage regulation is equal to 19.052 minus 18.48 divided by 18.48 into 100. So this will become 3.125%. So now coming to the part C. So part C, it is asked to find the efficiency. So first we will know the losses. Losses I can calculate as 3 times of IR square into R. So this will become 3 into whatever IR is obtained in this one. So 0.157 square into R, if you multiply, I am directly writing the answer, 0.185 megawatt will come here. Similarly, the power output P will be equal to 3 times of V phase into I phase. You have to multiply with cos phi R. So this will become 3 into 18.48 into 0.157 into power factor is 0.8, because kilo multiplied it becomes mega. So this becomes 6.96 megawatts. So from this I can calculate my efficiency. Efficiency is equal to P divided by P plus losses multiplied by 100. So this will become 6.96 divided by 6.96 plus 0.185 into 100. So this will become equal to 97.4%. So in this way you have to calculate this. I hope the concept of short transmission line, how to calculate the transmission line parameters, that is regulation and efficiency of the short transmission line, is completely clear to you. If you still have any queries, you can leave your comments in the comment section below. And I forget to tell that I am providing all the material in the link below. You can check in the description. You can download the material from there also. Thank you. Thank you very much.